Hey class, in this week's video we're going to be reviewing the grain size distribution plot determined using the sieve analysis test. So the sieves are behind me, we're going to be using dry soil, we're going to be passing this dry soil through the sieves. The sieves will filter out different particle sizes based off of the diameter, and then from taking the mass of each range of particle size, we can create our grain size distribution. Our grain size distribution is then in classifying the soil and finding these two key indexes called the coefficient of uniformity and the coefficient of curvature, and that should all be covered in the lecture portion. So as we already mentioned in the lecture portion, the sieve and sieves themselves are pretty much just mechanical filters. So you can see this is the largest sieve we're going to be using, number 4 sieve. Each sieve has a classification number 4, here would be this one, and then a corresponding opening or area of opening size. So 4,750 microns is 4.75 millimeters. So this is going to be our top sieve, our number 4 sieve. This separates the gravel to the sands and fines. So anything retained on this sieve is going to be our gravel size particles. Anything that passes it is going to be our sands and our fines. So you can use a lot of different types of sieves. In this lab, we're going to be using 8 different sieves, and that's so we can have a nice smooth curve. But again, you could use however many sieves you want depending on the type of soil that you're going to be expected to be using. This is the soil that we're using. And if you look at it, it looks like a bunch of mixture of particles, right? You can kind of see some large coarse grain particles. Then you can also see a lot of dust, a lot of fines, this like flour-like material. So we should also have some fines in this material as well. So we'll go through each one individually, but this is our 200 sieve. So this is going to be our smallest sieve. So you can see 200, larger number, but it opens 75 microns. This is really, really small. You can see it just looks like an opaque piece of paper, right? This is going to separate our sands and our fines. So anything that passes this is going to be called our fines, which is going to be our silts and our clays. Anything that is retained on this is going to be our sands. So you can see these are the sieves we're going to use. They are dirty. So first step we need to do is clean them. We're going to use compressed air and a brush. Because we want to have no residual soil, or at least try to get all the residual soil in these sieves that we can. So that'll be the first step, and then we're going to take the mass of each one empty. We've taken all the empty masses. The next step is an important step. We need to organize our sieves so they are in ascending order. So we'll start on the bottom here with the pan. Next will be our 200 sieve. Then we have our 140 sieve. After that, 100 sieve. 80 sieve, 40 sieve, 20 sieve, 10 sieve, then finally our number 4 sieve. So this is the soil we're going to be using. It's about 1.5 kilograms, so about 1500 grams. And the important thing now is to pour this in the top very, very slowly to make sure no dust is flowing up or anything. Then we'll put the cap on and then we'll place this whole apparatus in a shaker, a mechanical shaker that will just shake it for about 15 minutes. And that 15 minutes, then we're going to assume that all the material has had enough time to filter through and be retained on whatever filter size or sieve is corresponding to the actual particle diameter. So these have now been in the shaker for roughly 10-15 minutes. Again, we're going to assume that it's been agitated enough that all the materials filtered through and had enough time and enough agitation where the particles will actually retain on each sieve. So next step now, we're going to carefully disassemble each sieve and then take the mass of each sieve full. So there's going to be soil retained on each one. We're going to use this as our M full for the sieve. And of course, when we subtract the empty weight of each sieve out from that, we can get the soil, the mass of soil that's retained on each one. So we'll do that really carefully. We can't let any material spill during this process. So we've separated each sieve now. You can see equal representation of each particle size. And you can also see now when we get into this really fine material, this stuff has a lot of volume, but low amount of mass, right? Because it's just really small light particles. So now the next step would be to take the mass of each one of these without spilling anything, and then empty it all back into our single container, and we'll take the mass of this and compare it to our original mass and see if we've lost any mass and comment on the percent of the total mass that has been lost or gained or anything, and how that may contribute to the total potential sources of error in this experimentation. Another thing that we would do too is we're going to keep everything that was passed through the number 40 sieve. Now the number 40 sieve will then be used for our hydrometer lab. So remember, this sieve analysis is only for coarse-grained soils. We can't distinguish between clays and silts. We need to use the hydrometer lab to do that, and that's why we would keep all of this fine-grained material here, 40 and under, and that's what we're going to be using for next week's lab. So look at the data spreadsheet, because there's too many masses and things to include in the video, so I'm providing a spreadsheet for you this time, but make sure to follow the table in the back of your procedures, because that's going to be a primary report deliverable, as well as your grain size distribution plot. Okay, so I want you guys to notice this potential source of error, or not really potential, it is a source of error, right? After we got done measuring the mass of each one full, you can see we have some leftover dust. This dust was on the bottom of each sieve, and this is our soil from our 200, our 100, and I think our 40 sieve. So it passed some soil, but it was still stuck to the bottom, and obviously this amount of soil is not accounted for in our masses. So this is soil that is just going to be like disappearing, I guess. So this is just a source of error that you have to account for. We're not always going to have a perfect seal on our sieves. That's why multiple tests are usually ran instead of just one trial to get your grain size distribution curve.